right, Shalom. Shalom, Koholo, Koholo, YHWH, Koholo, YHWH. I want to give all praise, honor, and glory to YHWH, Shem, Kakadosh, the Mohren to the Apostles, and the Elders of Greatmillstone. And it's sincere Shalom to the Akhenets out there pushing the sincerity and the truth and that sound doctrine. I'm a one from the GMS Baltimore camp. And I wouldn't even call this, I guess it's a short testimony, but I really wouldn't even call it that, you know. Just something, you know, it's something I've been kind of going through, you know, for like the past, it's all started probably like the past, you know, going on 2 weeks now. Basically, you know, I'm just going to kind of jump straight into it. Since this whole COVID thing started, things have been, you know, kind of changing. You know, and it can't see, and this goes to what we were saying, like, you know, we know things are going to change in the world, but we have got to be prepared for a lot of things to change in these camps. Okay, so, recently, you know, things have been changing, and what I mean by things changing, I mean Jake falling out, and, you know, like, for example, like recently, I think a couple weeks ago, we recently had a guy that just up and left. You know, he just up and left. Okay. And, basically he called one of the brothers, but he didn't call anybody else. And we had no idea until that other brother told us. And basically he just, you know, up and left. And when you see stuff like that, you can't, you know, when you start seeing stuff like that, you can't. All types of thoughts start coming through your head, like, you know, it's a Lord, you know, and especially camp leaders, you know, I can only imagine what camp leaders go through when they see, you know, their men just drop out, man, you know, they be thinking like, you know, what am I doing? You know, am I doing something right? You know, am I doing something right? You know, the Lord dealing with us, you know? Like, you know, should we just fold now, you know, type thoughts start coming through your head, but through the camp leader, it funnels on down to the men, to the men that's over that person that fell out. And then we all start getting the same, you know, vibration from the same thoughts, you know, that stuff happens, that stuff does happen. So basically, you know, after that, like, literally, I think the next day, actually, after camp, that's when them stupid, dumb thoughts and demonic thoughts, they're calling them demonic, you know, very demonic, you know, demonic thoughts start coming through my head, like, you know, like, you be looking around like, man, you know, what I got the Bible for, you know, sitting there praying, like, what are you praying for, you know, what's making you pray, you know, what's making you do that stuff? You know, is the Lord really dealing with you? You know, demons start jumping in your head, make you think like that. You know, and that's what the thoughts, and I've been having that for years. I'm talking about years now. But what they did was they came and they went. But starting sometime last week, it lasted all week long. All day long, all week long, and they just never went anywhere. In fact, it got worse, and it started getting worse and worse and worse. It just started getting worse, you know, and that's the type of demons that we have to fight. But throughout all that, I still kept pushing, you know, I still kept pushing throughout all that, you know. I was still pushing videos like crazy, you know, I was still pushing, you know, part of that could be a little bit of overthinking too, you know, as one of the brothers, a couple of the brothers, you know, brought that to my attention, that part of that could be overthinking too, but overall, that ain't nothing but a demon, you know, trying to get you, and try to make you fall out, okay, and man, I'm gonna get this scripture here, and just line it up with scriptures now. This is Job 5:17. It says, "Behold, happy is the man whom YHWH correcteth. Therefore, despise not thou the chastening, of the Almighty. So I'm gonna read that again. It says, behold, happy is the man whom Yahweh Shem Yahusha correcteth. Therefore despise not thou the chastening of the Almighty. So that's like a you know, that's the Lord chastening me, man. You know. And of course, and you know, another thing I said was, you know, this is another thing you gotta do if you're going through this. There's another thing you gotta do. The water Yahweh Shem Yahusha. I'm talking about if you're a brother, the water Yahweh Shem Yahusha. Because, you know, what did it just say? It said, blessed is the man, you know, who the Lord correcteth. I was probably doing something wrong. You know, I was probably getting out of control. And, you know, the Lord sending these demons to settle down, you know, settle me down. Because when I have those thoughts, I'd be like, you know, what did I do? You know, when I do something wrong, and, you know, because that's what you got to pray for mercy for, man. Because, you know, we be sinning, and you don't know, man. You know, you be committing sins and you just don't know. That comes from us being in the flesh. Is it our fault? No. But that's what we got to pray. You know, because, again, that just comes from us being in the flesh. So, you know, it said, happy is the man who the Lord corrected, you know. So that's why when because I remember praying for this real hard. I remember praying for the Lord to build up our spirit, because the times we in right now, you know, that's mainly why I said the water Yahweh Shem Yahusha, because that's the Lord building up my spirit. And that's another thing you gotta remember, man. When the Lord is doing that to you, send them crazy ass thoughts to your head, man, just saying, oh, you should fall out. What should you do? You know? What should you do? That means you have to pray more. You have to pray a whole lot more. You have to pray really hard. The Lord is going to give us that raw spirit. The Lord is going to give us that you know, that power to endure, to resist. And I'm going to get that, to resist the devil. That's how you control those thoughts, man. That's how you prevent those thoughts from making you bug the hell out. You know? Because that guy that just left, he ain't believe. He ain't never believe. You know what he was doing? He was sitting on the side. You know, he don't do videos in two goddamn weeks. You know, that's what demons do to you. And you know, since he came in, you know, I hate to say it, I love the brother. I did, and I you know, believe it or not, I still do. And Lord willing, he get himself together. Obviously, he can't come back here because this guy already, you know, that sealed his fate, man. You know, he was ready to quit before. You know, and what happened? You know, the elder, you know, brought him back. You know, because that's what we do. That's all. We have to show that brotherly love. But if they ready to go, then they ready to go. That ain't nothing but demons, man. You know, and I'm sure he had those same thoughts of, you know, why are you doing this? You could go elsewhere. It could be easier. You ain't gotta do no videos. You ain't gotta do nothing. So what he doing? You know, he ain't doing no videos. He said he doing the same thing. The demons he had here, and I'm not gonna make this video about him, but the demons he had here carry right on over there. That's what demons do, okay? That's exactly what demons do. Okay, now let me get another scripture. You know, enough of the talking. You know, Book of Psalm 34. And 7, it says, the angel of the Lord encampeth round about them that fear him, and delivereth them. Let me repeat that. It says, the angel of the Lord encampeth round about them that fear him, and delivereth them. You know, what's that saying? You know, a psalm is real good for, you know, uplifting, you know, and prayer. Because, you know, that's saying, that's really self-explanatory. Angels encamp around those, and you know, they surround those that fear the Lord, you know. You got a lot of guys in this thing that really don't fear the Lord, you know. And I pray, and this is why I pray, you know. And I remember since this COVID thing started, I remember saying, I think in quite a few videos, that, you know, when this COVID thing is going to make people, you know, make Jake really bug out, and it's going to make him fall out. And this is why another thing I said in the videos is I pray that I'm not one of those people. I pray that the remaining brethren are not one of those people, you know, because it's easy for us to say that, you know, but we have to make sure we didn't witness about a thousand times where words that people said turned right back on, came right back on. So I could easily say, like for example, like RFID chip, I could easily say I'm not going to take that. You know, I could easily say I'm not going to take that. Do I know that? Of course not. I say Lord willing. You know, that's Jake don't understand the importance, you know, of remaining humble and faithful. Okay. All right. So, you know, this is James. I'm just kind of rolling with the scriptures right now. This is James 1:12. Okay. James 1:12. It says, blessed is the man that endureth temptation. Okay. It said, blessed is the man that endureth temptation. What I was going through ain't nothing but a temptation, you know, trying to make me fall out. But then in my spirit, because that's what prayer does. In my spirit, I was like, well, what happens if you fall out? What then? You know, you think shit going to get better for you? No, it's going to get worse. You basically turned your back. You know, you done basically turned your back. That was the main thing that kept me pushing, man. The main thing, like, man, if you fall out, man. You know, I look at my neighbors. They still trying to have birthday parties. They still doing everything they trying to do to keep the new to keep the normal going, man. To keep them from bugging out. But it ain't working. You know, it ain't working for them. You know, to keep us from bugging out is the HallowedRide and YHWH. That's the only thing that's going to keep you from bugging out. These people out here don't know no better. You know, these people out here want life to go back to normal. You know, and we have to stay in that spirit of, we don't want this bitch to go back to normal. It could, you know, it could. But then again, that's where reality comes in. We don't know. We don't know. So that's another thing. This place, you know, what happens if this thing do bounce back to some degree? You know what a lot of Jake gonna do? They gonna lose faith. And I pray that I do not do that. You know? And I pray that the brothers out there, you know, I pray that the brothers, you know, that are still pushing, don't lose faith. You know? Because you know what happens when something happens, you're super on fire. Then when temptation comes, you know, you start getting these thoughts like, man, the Lord ain't even here. You know, the Lord ain't even here. I thought time was close. A lot of people don't know that being on the Lord's time. Not on our own time. Okay. But anyway. It says, for when he is tried, he shall receive the crown of life, which the Lord hath promised to them that love him. You know. Let me get another scripture. So it said, when you were tried, you know, you won't be trying in this thing, man, you know. And, you know, since I was so young, you know, coming into this thing, I was like 12 years old when I first came into this thing. Man, this thing about a good 9 years now. And that's another thing, man. 9 years of what? You know, 9 years of pushing, you know, and you ready to fall out now? Like, what the hell is wrong with you? That's what came in my head. Like, man, what the fuck wrong with you? And excuse the language, but what the hell wrong with you? You know, then 9 years of fuck, you know? So I've been in this thing for about, you know, like I said, since I was, you know, 12, you know, and I never really, understood the, you know, the true importance of prayer, because, you know, my mind was elsewhere. You know, I'm so young, I want to do other, you know, I want to do things. Me and the elder was just talking about that, you know. You want to do other things, you know. Hey, you want to be there, and it's good that you know and all that, but your mind look away, you know, your mind elsewhere. But as I started getting older, you know, things started to show, you know, at least a little older. I'm still young, man. I'm not trying to sound like no elder. things started to show. I started to see a little more, you know. Like just now, you know, I'm seeing a lot more, and that the Lord is really starting to put hell on me, man. You know, which is good, you know. And not like I said, what you do is you the water YHWH Shem Yahushah, because that's a good sign that perhaps the Lord is dealing with you. You know, I certainly hope the Lord is dealing with me, man. I certainly hope so. You know, I certainly hope the Lord is dealing with all the brothers that's out there, man. You know. But yeah, the last thing you want to see, you know, it's bad enough we gotta see two-thirds full, and they our people and all. I mean, we happy, but we're not, because they're still our people. But at the same time, we are happy because we know they're gonna be brought back right, you know. But you don't want to see a Jake that's been pushing with you for the longest time fall. You know, not even just for a long time. You know, a Jake that you see is willing and they ready to fall out, man. You know, we always try to do that. We always try to bring them back. Okay? So this is, let me see. Give me a second. This is 1 Corinthians 10 to 13. It says, therefore, so like 1 Corinthians 10 to 13. It says, there have no temptation taking you, but such as is common to man. But Yahweh is YHWH is faithful, Salakim, who will not suffer you to be tempted above that ye are able. I'm gonna read that actually. It says, there have no temptation taking you, but such as is common to man, but YHWH by Shem Yahushua is faithful, who will not suffer you to be tempted above that ye are able. What is that saying? It said tempted, that you are not tempted above that ye are able. What's that saying? Well, that's basically saying that the Lord is not going to give you nothing that you can't handle. You know, the Lord knows what you can handle, what you can't. That's why people, you know, you may go through something that's probably not as bad as another brother is going through, but it's how you take it, you know. It's your spirit, you know, it's your spirit. But in all reality, if one brother is going through more than the other, and that brother that's not going through as much as that one brother is feeling is reacted to it, to his problem the same exact way as the brother that's going through a whole lot, that means it's really no different, you know, if you really want to think about it. Because it's like, you could look at it like, ain't nothing, you know, you pick your ass back up and, you know, you better fight that. That's easy for you to say, you know, which means it's really no different. There's no really, really no different of a hell, you know, if you know what I'm saying. Okay, so basically, the Lord gives you things that you can handle, and that's another inspiration for me, man. The Lord always gives you things that you can handle. He will never give you something that you can't handle, you know. Okay, it says, but with the temptation. Also make a way to escape that ye may be able to bear it, right? So we gotta be able to bear that temptation, man. You know, temptation. You know, it could be, you know, it could be anything, man. It could be anything, you know. Demons jump in your head. Hey, man, fall out. You know you want to, you know. You know you want to. And other demons are different than some, but... You know, it's all, like I said, it's all the same thing, man. It's all the same deal. They all demons, man. Bottom line is we got to pray to keep, let me get that real quick. Okay, I just, kind of lined up with scriptures, and you know, it may be a long video, it may not be, but you know, I'm just kind of, you know, lined up with this, with the scriptures here, you know. Just kind of going through, this is Luke 21 and 36. Now this is a basic one that, you know, all brothers basically know. This is Luke 21 and 36. It says, "Watch ye therefore, and pray always, that ye may be accounted worthy to escape all these things that shall come to pass, and to stand before the Son of Man." I'm gonna repeat that. It says, "Watch ye." It means you gotta watch. You know, you gotta watch, and you know, when watch yourself, watch over the brotherhood and all that. You know, it says, "Watch ye therefore, and pray always." It says, "Pray always." You know, that's the key. You know, and me and the elder did a video not too long ago, a couple weeks ago, and we said, we mentioned that when you pray, everything else comes right along with that. When you pray, everything comes. You know, as far as how not to take the chip, that was the title, how not to take the chip. You know, when you pray, all of that comes with it. All of that comes with it. Okay. Your faith, everything. Because it just said it. It said that ye may be accounted worthy to escape all these things that shall come to pass. So, you know, we gotta pray to become worthy to escape all these things that's gonna come to pass. You know, that hell that's coming, you know, that hell that's coming to this place, you know, the temptations, the devils, man. You know, we gotta be ready. Shalaka. We gotta be ready to pray, you know. Okay, here goes one here. I had a few written down. I had it in my head, but then I lost train of thought, so I had to look at it again, you know. But I lost it again. All right. This is Galatians 5 and 16. It says, "This I say then, walk in the Spirit," right? "Ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh." You see that? It says, for the flesh lust of against the Spirit. You know, them demons, them demonic ass thoughts, that ain't nothing but you know, flesh. You know, which is still spiritual. It's still spiritual because they're getting inside you. Those are spirits too. You know, those are spirits too. Now I remember that them demons only fulfilling, like Satan, he only fulfilling what the Lord set him up to do. You know, a lot of people think, you know, the Lord against Satan. You know, they having a war, and first of all, that don't make any sense, but that's another video. But Satan only doing you know, the Lord's will. And you know, when the Lord tells Satan, "Hey, all right, get him, test him, see if he gonna fall or not. You know, see if he gonna fall or not. See if he gonna stay faithful to me or not. Get him." You know, then that's what that is. You know, Satan gotta obey. You know, in fact, let's get that. We actually just recently passed by that couple days ago in the book of Luke, you know, to prove that this is all the Lord's doing, you know, because you know, Satan tried to tempt the Lord, you know. So I'm talking about YHWH. You know, he tried to tempt YHWH. You know, and if YHWH tried, you know, if he tried that with YHWH, who are we? You know, of course we gonna go through that. Okay, of course we're going to go through that. If I'm not mistaken, I think we're on the mountain here. Okay, right here. Yeah, it says, "And YHWH," this is Luke chapter 4. And I'm going to read up to 6. This is Luke chapter 4. It says, "And YHWH, being full of the Holy Ghost," or the Holy Spirit, "returned from Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness," okay, It said being 40 days tempted of the devil, and which means he was coming at him hard. Okay? It said, and in those days he did eat nothing. And when they were ended, he afterward hungered. Okay? Meaning, I'm guessing meaning he fast, you know. It said, and the devil said unto him, if thou be the son of Yahweh, command this stone that it may be bread. And YHWH answered, saying, it is written that that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word of YHWH. What's that? That's faith. You know, a lot of people, like when these famines come, you know, that's a prime example. That's a good example for, you know, when these famines come, which they are right around the corner. They're already technically here. You know, a lot of people trying to stock up on food, you know, things like that. Jake think food going to save him, man. No, it's going to be these scriptures. Even if we starve to death, man, we do it for the truth. Because some of us are going to starve to death. You know, we're going to be starved, you know, but it's all up to the Lord. It's all up to the Lord, whatever he has in store for you. So yeah, man, food, you know, that goes to that food. That means having faith. That's the point of this lesson. Having faith, you know, faith is very important. Okay. Prayer is very important, you know, and that's how you have faith. You have prayer, you know. And when you pray, by the way, man, when you pray, you know, because you got a lot of guys like the guy that just recently left. Yeah, I prayed, you know, and, you know, but you pray, you can't just sit up there and say, hey, I'll wash on the outside, you know, give me this and give me, you know. No, you can't be like that, man. You gotta believe, man. You gotta believe. And even if you are in that sluggish, yeah, you make sure you believe, man. You know, you gotta be into it. And a lot of Jake ain't into it. And that's exactly why that guy left, man. That's exactly why Jake leave. Because these demons, the demon of the world, they worried about the world. They worried about everything else, man. Okay? I'm gonna get that soon. This is verse 5. It said, and the devil taking him up into an high mountain, shewed unto him all the kingdoms of the world in a moment of time. And the devil said unto him, all this power will I give thee, and the glory of them, for that is delivered unto me, and to whomsoever I will give it. Okay? If thou therefore will worship me, all shall be thine. What's that saying? Satan was like, you see all this? I give you everything. You know, I give you everything. The whole world will be yours. Watch this. What the Lord said. Well, what YHWH said. It said, and YHWH answered and said unto him, get thee behind me, Satan. Okay. And so the Lord said, fuck are you? Get behind me. You know, you don't run this. I run this. You know, it says, for it is written, thou shalt worship the Lord thy power. Okay? And him only shalt thou serve. You see that? That's the only way we gonna resist the devil, man. That's the only way we gonna resist the devil. It's through the power of YHWH, Shem El Shai. Let me get this real quick, because a lot of people say, you know, a lot of people have these you know, and again, man, this is to help other people. This is to help other brothers. I mean, this is to help the other brothers. And even some sisters that may be, you know, being tempted like that, man. You know, because you got guys out there that just, you know, are let me get that. I'm kind of all over the place right now with this, but you know, it's all through the spirit of YHWH, you know. Let me get this. All right, because remember I said, ain't no way you're going to get through the troubles and all this without YHWH, right? This is Ephesians 6 and 10. It says, finally, so like, give me a second. It says, finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord. This is Ephesians 6 and 10. All right. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh. Right? It said, put on the whole armor of Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh. How do you put on the whole armor? Well, through your prayers. You said, I'm going to be going here through your prayers. You know, I'm going to close it out soon. You know, and you know, doing the work, basically doing the Lord's work. You know, you're praying, you're basically doing the Lord's work. It said that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. That's what I'm talking about.